everyone. I, Sheetal Badesra, Faculty of BBA Department from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I will be delivering a lecture on theories of entrepreneurship development. Before that, you should be aware about the concept of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is defined as the act of being an entrepreneur. That is, an entrepreneur is one who undertakes innovations, finance, and business activities. Entrepreneurship is an effort to transform innovations into economic goods or services. Now, I shall discuss the theories of entrepreneurship development. In general, there are many theories of entrepreneurship, and I will be discussing few of them, including economic theory of entrepreneurship, number two, sociological theory of entrepreneurship, next, entrepreneurship innovation theory, psychological theory of entrepreneurship, theory of achievement motivation, theory of leadership, theory of systematic innovation. Let's discuss them one by one, starting with the very first theory, that is economic theory of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship and economic growth takes place when economic conditions are favorable. Economic incentives are the main motivators. Economic incentives include taxation policy, industrial policy, sources of finance and raw material, infrastructure availability, investments and marketing opportunities. Richard Cantillon, an Irish-French economist, viewed entrepreneurs as an agent who buys factors of production at certain price in order to combine them with a view to selling it at certain prices in future. He illustrated farmer as an entrepreneur who pays out contractual incomes to the landlords and laborers, which are certain, while sells his crops at a price which is uncertain. He perceived entrepreneur as a risk taker. Number two, sociological theory of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is likely to get a boost in a particular social culture. The behavior of individuals in a society is influenced by society's values, religious beliefs, customs. The entrepreneur merely performs a role as per the expectations of the society. Number three, entrepreneurship innovation theory. This theory was promoted by Joseph Schumpeter. According to him, entrepreneurship is an innovation. This theory ignores earlier two abilities, which were till then considered key for an entrepreneur: organizing abilities and risk-taking abilities. According to Joseph Schumpeter, a 20th century Austrian economist, an entrepreneur is a person who is willing and able to convert new ideas or inventions into a successful innovation. Entrepreneurship resulted in new industries, even though it entailed combining the existing inputs in a new way. Schumpeter's example of innovation was the combination of steam engine with a wagon cart to produce the horseless carriage. In this case, the innovation, the car, was transformational, but it did not require the development of new technology. Merely the application of existing technology in a novel manner was entrepreneurial. Number four, psychological theory of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship gets boost when society has sufficient supply of individuals with necessary psychological characteristics. These psychological characteristics include need for achievement, a vision, foresight, ability to face opposition. These characteristics are formed during the individual's upbringing or by high standard of excellence, self-reliance, and low further dominance. Number five, theory of achievement motivation. This theory was given by David McClelland. He identified need for achievement, need for affiliation, need for power as the basis of entrepreneurial personality. He emphasized the importance of achievement motivation, though which entrepreneur fulfills economic and social development. The need for achievement was found highest among entrepreneurs through an experiment, the Kakinada experiment, conducted by McClint in America, Mexico and India. Young adults were selected and put through a 3 months training to induce achievement motivation. Trainees imagined themselves in need of challenges and success and to set achievable goals. They imitate their role models. Positive impact on performance. Traditional beliefs do not inhibit. Through this, McClint identified two characteristics of entrepreneurship. Number one, doing things in a new and better way. Number two, decision making under uncertainty. He stressed that people with high achievement orientation are more likely to become entrepreneurs. People are not influenced by money or external incentives. Profits are only a measure of success and competency. Next, theory of leadership. According to Hoselitz, entrepreneurship is a function of managerial skills and leadership. It includes ability to lead and manage. Social conditions should ensure that development of enterprise-oriented personalities. Hoselitz emphasized on the role of culturally marginal groups. Next theory, theory of systematic innovation. Professor Drucker developed this theory. Systematic innovation consists in the purposeful and organized search for changes and in the systematic analysis of opportunities such changes might offer the economic or social innovation. Systematic innovation means 7 sources for innovative opportunities. The first 4 sources lie within the enterprise. These 4 sources are, number 1, the unexpected. The unexpected success, the unexpected failure, the unexpected outside event. Number 2, the incongruity between reality as it actually is and reality as it is assumed to be or ought to be. Number 3, innovation-based process need. Number 3, innovation based on process need. Number 4, changes in industry structure or market structure that catch everyone unaware. The second set of sources for innovative opportunity, a set of 3, involves change outside the enterprise of industry. Number 1, demographics. Number 2, change in perception, moods and meaning. Number 3, new knowledge, both scientific and non-scientific. Lines between these 7 sources, areas of innovative opportunities are blurred and considerably overlap between them. So, finally, I would conclude by saying entrepreneurship is a multidisciplinary area governed by human factors, ever-changing society, pursuing simultaneously economic objectives, social objectives, and psychological objectives. Theory of entrepreneurship is woven into sociological, cultural, psychological, political, and managerial fiber. With them, it forms a economic web. So, I hope that you have understood the concept and theories of entrepreneurship development by now. For more videos like this, kindly subscribe Technia TV. Thank you very much.